everyone. Welcome to Pour Painting with Ron. Well, in today's video, we're going to do another bloom pour, but this time we're going to use a black pillow paint rather than a white one. I did manage to get black after all. I'll tell you more about that in a little bit. But anyway, today we're going to be doing the painting on this 45 centimeter by 45 centimeter thick edge canvas. And just as I always do, I've taped off the back with some painter's tape just to keep it tidy, and I've put in some giant push pins that I got from Officeworks to keep it off the surface of the table, and then I've made sure my canvas was nice and tight. Now, as I said, I'm using a black pillow paint today. So all I did was go to my Bunnings warehouse and ask for a black white acrylic wall paint, and they just tinted it for me. So I've got this, I hope it works because I've got 4 liters to use. But this is just an untinted, this is just a low sheen interior water-based acrylic wall paint. And I had it tinted black because I'm using a black cell activator today. So I'm using black, and then my colours today, I'm going to be using all Joe Sonia's colours. They're nicely high pigmented colours. And I'm mixing them one part paint to two parts of my pouring medium. And the pouring medium that I use is two parts of the untinted wall paint. Same brand as this other wall paint, but untinted. It says it at the bottom of the can that it's untinted, and I go for the extra bright. So two parts of the untinted wall paint to, no, not two parts, three parts of the untinted wall paint, sorry, to two parts of varnish. So this is a Joe Sonia's polyurethane varnish. If you're in the States, polycrylic will work just as well. So two parts of the varnish to three parts of the untinted wall paint. And you mix that two parts of the pouring medium to one part paint. So I'm using Joe Sonia's, but any highly pigmented paint will do. So the colours today, I'm using some Brilliant Violet, and I'm using Napthol Crimson, let's see, Ultramarine Blue, and Aqua, or Turquoise really, and some nice rich gold. Now, if you've been following my videos, I did use exactly the same colours on a large rectangular canvas last time, and I used a white pillow paint, and I thought it would work better with a black pillow paint today. So we'll see how that goes. Now, the cell activator on the top today, I'm using Amsterdam. They work really well. And I'm using their Oxide Black or Black Oxide, just the standard series. One part of the paint to three parts of the Floetrol. Clear as mud. I do go everything in more detail in the first video that I did using a bloom pour, and I'll put a link to that one at the end of this video if you want more details. But anyway, I'll put all of this away and then we'll get started. Alrighto, we're back and ready to start. Now, before I put my pillow on, I'll just show you how I mixed up my colours. I've put them in these little squeeze bottles that I got from the cheap shop, but you can keep it for ages in these squeeze bottles. I always mix up more than I need, and I keep all of my colours at hand, so I can just pick them off the shelf when I want them. I give them a bit of a shake, and then they're ready to go. It works really well. All right. Now, I'm using a black pillow paint because I'm using the black cell activator. So I want a nice dark looking painting today. Last time when I used the white pillow paint, the little air bubbles that were still in the paint popped and the white showed through, which didn't really give it a good look. And you also run the chance too that the white will show through as well if you don't have enough colour on the top. So I think a black pillow will solve most of those problems for me today. Well, that's the plan anyway. All right, so I've mixed my paint. It's very full, first painting I've done with it. And I'll pour out some paint onto my canvas. Now, it's not as black as artist paints, but certainly a lot more black than it is white. Okay, now I'll just spread it out with my palette knife, and then I'll put some more on the canvas for the paint to slide over. So if you don't have enough paint on the canvas, your colour isn't going to move across the top, and then you won't get your bloom painting. Pillow of paint in the middle. Oh. I think that's the middle, thereabouts. Now you need to make sure you've got enough to carry the paint all the way over the sides of your canvas. I think I use about a litre or so in the end, which probably works out the same to like a flint cut pour or something. Looks like a lot of paint, and it is, but it's probably no more than a flint cut pour. Bubbles. So you're never going to pop all of them. Are we in the middle? I think so. Now it's going to be a bit of a drizzle pour, this one. Painted my gloves. I'm going to start, I will leave the gold till last. I'll put the darker colours on first. I did shake them before. I'll just give it a little bit more of a shake. And you can put the paint on in any pattern that you desire. I'm just going to drizzle it on. Because it's a square canvas, I'll do like a square drizzle. I'll sort of make my square. So I'm sort of aiming for the middle. About the middle, thereabouts, and then I'll just drizzle it on like so. I'm hoping I've got enough for two paintings today. Then I'll do some of the purple. Just drizzle it on. And then I'll do the aqua or turquoise. This colour combination is really lovely, especially with the gold on it. And then I'll do the red. The colour that you put on last is the the colour that's really going to show up the most. I think so anyway. And then this lovely rich gold colour. I do want plenty of that. Right. Now, you can use multiple things to move your paint over the canvas. I'm going to be using playing cards today. You can use a palette knife or a bit of plastic, or you can blow it with a blow dryer. Never had much success with that, but I found play cards work reasonably well, or just a bit of cut up plastic that all works. Okay, and I'm using my paint wall scraper, so I'm going to put my cell activator on the paint scraper, and then I'm going to drag it over the canvas. As I said, that the Amsterdam seems to work particularly well to create the lacing effects. Not every paint will work the same way. So I put a bit on my paint scraper and then I just dab the end in, make sure I've got some good coverage. Okay, I'm going to start about the middle. And then pull out to the side like so. As you can see, that the lacing starts to form already. So just like that. Do the corners last. I'll start here and go like so. Interesting. I think I've done as much as I'm going to do. Now, before I spin it out, and I forgot to do this last time, I will wreck it a little bit. So I'll just run a wooden skewer through the painting just to create some interesting lines. So this is about the middle. And so I'll just go like so. Overdo it. Let's clean off the skewer. Now I'm going to wash up some of my tools and give this a little bit of time to develop, and then I'll come back and spin it out. So we'll see you soon. Okay, so I'm back. I think the lacing has developed as much as it's going to. I'll move the camera to the swimming pool on the ground, and you'll be able to see how we spin out the painting to create the surprise. So welcome to my super fancy spinning setup. As you can see, I've done a few paintings in here because my plastic is just getting really gross, but it still works perfectly well, so I'm not about to change it. Now the canvas I'm using is quite large and thick, so I've turned a bucket upside down in the baby pool just to keep my spinner up a bit higher so the painting doesn't get caught on the bottom of the pool. It's done that to me before, not very good. So it's up nice and high, but not too high so the sides can still catch any paint that flings off. Now you can put your painting straight onto your spinner. I'm just using a pottery banding wheel, but a cake spinner will work, or a lazy Susan. I've just put a board on the top just to make the surface a bit larger. Makes it a bit easier to put larger canvases on it. And I've just folded over some painter's tape here just to give the painting a bit of extra cling so it doesn't fling off while I'm doing my spinning. So I'll get my painting and we'll get started. Okay, excuse my lovely painting footwear. I'll get my paint in the middle. It's in the middle. Now, the trick is to get it into the middle of your board here. Now, I'll just turn it this way. Now, I'll do a little short spin. No, that's not the middle. To lift it up and put it like so. Yeah, that's not the middle. Move that way a little bit. Give me a bit of a trick to get it exactly where you want it. Okay, I think we're good now. Now step out of the pool or I will paint myself. Okay. Let me spin. And hopefully the magic will happen. Okay, I'll give it a bit more of a spin. The trick is getting your corners covered. If you don't have enough, it's a bit hard getting to your corners, but I think we're going to make it. Until we had most of the paint, lots of has fallen off here, not so much off that side yet, but we'll keep spinning until we're happy. Got all the corners covered. Now it's just a matter of spinning until I'm happy with the final look. Okay, well, it's looking nice. I don't want to overdo it. I will do another one. So the sides are covered as well. The paint I put there before just helps the other paint slide down when it gets to the end. The gold is nice and shimmery. It's a lovely gold that Joe Sonia's makes. Let me see, I'll stand up. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to spin that anymore. I don't want to ruin it. But I do think that's really lovely. Now I'm happy with that. I'm not going to spin it. There's a risk of wrecking it if I do. I think that's awesome. I'll just let it drip for a second and then I'll put it back on the table and I'll bring you in for a closer look. I hope you can see the painting. I'm holding the camera above my head. I think it turned out beautiful. So I'll bring you in for a closer look here. The lacing is just lovely. I think using the black as a pillow worked really well. You can see where there were air bubbles in the paint. They created black dots, but it's much less obvious than white dots if I would be using the white pillow paint. The gold is lovely, with like very shimmery when it dries. So, what do you think? I think it turned out really well. I think the black pillow paint with the black lacing is a great success and certainly something that I will keep playing with on new paintings, in going into the future. Maybe that's something you'd like to try yourself. If you do, please share how you go, and if you do have any questions or comments, please put them in the comments section under the video. I do read them all and I do reply to any questions that I get. Now, as usual, if you like what you saw today, please press the like button. It helps my videos get found on YouTube. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, please take a moment to subscribe. So I hope you stay well, especially in this COVID time. And I look forward to seeing you again next time. So, happy painting!